and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to discuss subqueries. We're going to go over standard subqueries and nested subqueries. A subquery is a query linked to another query, allowing values from a query to be passed to another query. Now keep in mind that subqueries are very similar to join queries because they allow you to query multiple tables at one time. For our first query, we're going to query the customer table and the orders table. Now the customer table contains all the customers and the orders table contains all the orders, and they are linked through the customer ID field. The customer ID field in the customer table is a primary key column, and the customer ID field in the orders table is a foreign key column. So for our first query, we're going to display the name and addresses of all customers who purchased two specific plans. So here you see the main query, and this here is considered the subquery. All subqueries are enclosed in parentheses. So you see the opening parentheses and the closing parentheses, and that's how you can identify a subquery within a subquery query. So we're going to start here at the bottom, select the customer ID from the orders table right here, where the plan ID is N or equal to L2004 or L2001. And then at the top, our top query says, select all the columns from the customer table where the customer ID is N or equal to the customer ID that was retrieved from this query. Because this query selects the customer ID from the orders table where the plan ID is N or equal to these two values. And then the above query says select all of the columns from the customer table where that customer ID is equal to the results retrieved from this query here. So we're going to click execute. And here you will see the customer ID of all the customers who purchased L2004 or L2001. Now keep in mind that whenever you have queries that are connected using the N keyword, you can only display columns from the query at the top. So as you can see, all of the columns that were retrieved came from the customer table, and none actually are shown from the orders table. Only the query at the top can display columns. So some would say, well, how can I actually see the orders alongside the customer names to ensure that these customers did buy those specific plans? So one way to do that is to use a join query. So I'll just show you an equivalent join query quickly. So in this join query, is select all of the columns using this period and use all for asterisk, all of the columns from the customer table and only the plan ID from the orders table. And then the from, you have to put both of the table names when you're doing a join query. And then in the where clause, you have to show the relationship between the tables. So here it says the customer ID is a foreign key in the orders table and the customer ID is a primary key in the customer table. And then additionally, we want to make sure that we retrieve all of the plan IDs, because here it says the plan ID from the orders. So we want only plan IDs that are N or equal to L2004 or L2001 like we had above. So we click execute, and here you will see that customer 3, 4, 7, and 8 is below. Customer 3 purchased plan ID L2001, which is one of the ones up here. And then you also see customer ID 7, she purchased both plans. So she has L2004 and L2001. So using a join query, you can display columns from either table, but when you use the regular standard subquery query, you can only display columns from the top query. For our next query, we're going to create a nested subquery. Now, nested subqueries are commonly used to create queries that contain aggregate functions. So we're going to create a subquery that contains an aggregate function called the count function. and we're going to display each customer's total number of orders. So let's take a look at our query. We're going to be showing the first name and the last name of all customers, as well as their total number of plans or orders. So what we have here is a nested subquery. Remember earlier I said all subqueries are enclosed in parentheses. So here's our subquery, and our main query is on the outside. Select first name and last name from customer. So you need to identify the fact that this is the subquery that's highlighted, and the main query is on the outside. Now the inner subquery makes a reference to the outer query in the where clause. Orders.customerID equals customer.customerID. So the inner query makes a reference to the outer query in the where clause, and it's executed once for every customer retrieved from the outer query, the main query. So the inner query says select all the records from the orders table, where the customer ID in the orders table is equal to the customer ID in the customer table. And once you get that value, the as keyword is used as an alias, and it's saying display that number for each customer as total plans. So it's an alias column that's created called total plans. Then the outer query says for all of these counts that you come up with, select the first name and the last name from the customer table and pair those names with the total plans count. Now keep in mind that it's very important that this comma is here, because the comma is telling the database to expect another column, and that other column is going to be called total plans. So we're going to click execute, and we should see the first and last name of all customers from the customer table, and then we should see the total amount of orders for each customer displayed as total plans. So we'll click execute, and as you can see here, you see the first name, the last name, and the total plans. So John Denton's has one order, Sam Elliott has three orders. I hope you enjoyed learning about subqueries today, and if you'd like more in-depth learning, please check out my SQL course in the description section below.